All right, welcome all to my tutorial on sentence mining using Tatoeba. This is for intermediate Japanese learners, however this could really be applied to any language, but it's especially useful for languages that make use of kanji in their writing systems. The prerequisites in order to use this technique are, of course, internet access, Anki, or the SRS of your choice. I chose Anki because it has excellent Japanese support, and also it's really easy to import files from Tatoeba into to Anki. I can't speak for the other SRSs that are out there. You'll also need access to a native Japanese speaker, and this is very important in order to catch any problems or any errors that are in there. Sometimes the sentences from Tatoeba aren't perfect, but a native Japanese speaker will be able to help you sort those out. Also, you'll need the ability to read hiragana and katakana. If you haven't gotten that far yet, then this tutorial is not for you. You should go back and learn how to do that, which really shouldn't take you very long. Also optional for this is Rikai-chan for Firefox or Rikai-kun for Chrome. Those are both very excellent plugins that'll help give you some dictionary support for your browser, and it'll let you mouse over any word that you don't know and see the reading for that word and the meaning of it. So here's your resources right here. These are both free. You can go to tatoeba.org and go ahead and make a free account there. There's really nothing to it besides just making an account. That's going to allow you to download all the sentences that you're going to want to use later on for your sentence mining. Also, you can get Anki. The desktop version is free. However, the mobile version for Anki or Android or whatnot is does cost money. However, it's definitely worth it to be able to have all of your reviews on you all the time. But go ahead and try out the desktop version for free, and you'll probably like it and go back and go ahead and buy the mobile version. Also, for Anki, be sure to download the Japanese support plugin. If you click on File, Download, Shared Plugin, it'll be one of the top ones that pop up there. It'll say Japanese support, and just go ahead and download that and restart Anki. So what is sentence mining? Sentence mining is collecting a lot of sentences that are right at your level, but then plus one thing that you want to learn. Maybe there's some kanji you don't quite understand yet, or one grammar point, or whatever the case is that you don't understand yet. So for an example, if I was trying to learn this kanji here, I might find a sentence that looked like this one right here. Now for this sentence, for my level, I can understand everything else in that sentence except for that kanji that's in red. So this is going to be an excellent sentence for me since I already know the meaning of the rest of it. And it's also especially good because I know the other kanji that's in that compound that makes up that word, so that makes it especially useful for me. All right, so now we're going to start getting into the actual technique here of how we're going to mine these sentences from Tatoeba. As you can see on the left side of my screen over here, I've already got Anki opened up to the deck that I'm going to be using for all my Japanese sentences. And then on the right side here, I've got Tatoeba opened up already, and I'm already logged into that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and open up the browser for all my sentences that I have in here. That's going to be important for a step later on when we're going to check some of these sentences to make sure that there's only one thing in there that we haven't previously studied. Sometimes it can get confusing with some kanjis that look really similar to each other, so you want to go ahead and make sure that when you're looking up something or adding some sentences in here that you're not adding in anything that's too difficult for you. Otherwise, you're going to have to delete them later on out. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead into Tatoeba, and I'm going to create a new list. The name really doesn't matter, so we're going to delete this list at the end of this tutorial here. So I'm just going to call this list A. That's usually what I do. I'm just going to hit create on that. So having this list created in Tatoeba is going to give us the ability to save all these target sentences that we're about to mine onto this list, and that's going to allow us to download that. So then up here in the from, I'm going to go ahead and select Japanese. And I'm going to have the definitions in English. And then I'm going to go ahead and type in the target word that I'm trying to learn here. And I'm going to pare it down to just the one kanji that I'm trying to learn. This will be good because this will give us a lot of different sentences where this kanji might be used just by itself, or it might be used in some other compounds with some other kanjis that we have already studied previously. So I'm going to go ahead and do a search for that kanji right there. And this will brought back 478 results of places where this kanji has been used before. So the first sentence right there that jumps out to me, there's some kanji in there that I don't know yet. So I'm going to skip over that first sentence. It also looks just really complicated and really cluttered, so that's kind of confusing right there. But you know, this next sentence that we've got here, this is pretty close to something that's my speed right there. So, you know, I can understand everything else in there with the exception of the one kanji that I'm trying to learn. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the add the favorites right there button. And then A is going to be already right there. I'm just going to hit OK. And then I'm going to go down. I'm going to select maybe, you know, 10, 15, or 20 sentences that have that kanji in them. If this kanji is used in a lot of different ways, I might go ahead and select even more. I might select 30 up to even 50. I wouldn't do more than 50 at a time, though. So I'm going to go ahead and just find some more kanjis. This sentence has this kanji right here. I don't know. This next sentence. Now let's say for this next sentence right here, this kanji might look kind of familiar. I don't know if I've studied this one before. I could have, you know, had it in a different compound before, so by itself it might look kind of, you know, different. But I'm going to go ahead and copy this and check it in my SRS here. And so one of my golden rules here is to only learn, you know, one thing at a time and not try and learn two different kanjis, new kanjis in one sentences unless it's, you know, absolutely have to. But as we can see, my search popped up with nothing, so I haven't studied that kanji yet, so I'm going to go ahead and skip over that sentence right there, and then later on I'll probably try and study that kanji, and this sentence will pop up, and hey, you know, I've already learned everything else in there, so that'll be something that I'll add in at that time, so don't worry about skipping over sentences, because there's plenty out there. In the event that you can't find a sentence with the kanji that you're trying to learn there in Tatoeba, you can go ahead and look up on other sources using Google, Wikipedia, or your as a last resort, you can get your Japanese friend to just type up a few sentences that where you know the rest of it, and hopefully your Japanese friend knows about what your level is there. You can go ahead and sign up for a tutoring service, or try and find somebody on lang8.com or something like that, and you can go ahead and find a Japanese person that way if you don't already have access to one. So let's check this one, you know, this kanji right here. I'm sure I know this one, but let's just say that I'm not quite sure if I've studied it yet. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that one and put that in here just to show you what this is going to show up as. So as you can see, I've studied this this kanji right here in four other sentences. So that's an excellent run for me right there, because, you know, I've only studied this other kanji a few times. So if I add this sentence in there, you know, maybe I skipped over this sentence last time because it had this kanji in there that I didn't know. So I'm going to go ahead and add that in there. So that gives us a pretty good selection. Usually I'd go on a little bit further and probably get another 5 or 10 extra sentences, but for the purpose of this tutorial, just we'll end with that right there. So I'm going to go back to Browse. I'm going to go to Browse by List. Underneath Browse by List, I've got A. That's the one that I created right there. And see, it's got the three sentences that we chose right in there. I can go ahead and close out the browser. I don't need that anymore right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Download this list. And then the translation, I'm going to go ahead and put English in there. And then I'm going to hit download. I'm going to take a note in the bottom that's saved as export list 721eng.csv. All right, so I'm going to go into Anki. And I'm going to do a file import. And then it should be the most recent one there. Sometimes there'll be you know, a bunch of other that you've brought in before. So it's going to be the last one in there. So I'm going to go ahead and hit open on that. I'm going to hit import right here. Something really neat here is if there's a sentence that's to double in your library there, maybe you imported it before and you didn't realize it, it's going to go ahead and exclude that, and it won't import again twice, so you're not going to end up with double sentences, which is a really excellent feature. Also, sometimes in Tatoeba, there will be multiple English definitions for one sentence, and in that case, it'll knock all of them off except for the first one that was in there. So I'm going to go ahead and close that out. Now, going back to my browser here, I'm going to scroll down to the bottom. I've got it in order of created. And as you can see, these last three down here don't have readings associated with them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and select these three. And I'm going to hit go to actions and regenerate readings. Now, this is where a lot of your errors are going to come in, is the readings that this comes up with aren't 100%. I'd probably say it's about, you know, 85 to 90% correct. So this is again where you need to have, especially on sentences that look kind of awkward or look kind of weird to you once you've been studying for a while, you can kind of guess that, hey, maybe this one's not right, and go ahead and have your Japanese friend there go ahead and check those for you, and then just put a note in the bottom of the sentence that's been checked, so you don't have to check it again in the future when you're not sure. So I've gone ahead and I've regenerated the readings for those. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to close out my browser again. I'm going to go back to my my list of decks and open this back up. I've had a problem before where the readings didn't show up right in the mobile version of Anki, unless I did a check database first. So I'm just going to go ahead and do a check database. I'm not sure if this step is essential anymore, but I just got in the habit of doing it. So, and then after that, I should be able to just go ahead and close that out, and it'll upload it up to the internet there, and I'll be able to access it with my my mobile version of Anki now. So there's the tutorial on that. I hope you've you know, gotten something from that. Go ahead and leave me comments or any other suggestions you've got. This is you know, the method that I use for my own studies. So whatever you're going to do, of course, is going to vary from that, and that's a good thing to develop your own method. This has worked for me, so I decided to share it with everybody else. So good luck on your studies, and ganbare.